Welcome back, everyone. We're kicking off Chili Week with Jeff Bloomer from Belly Yay. Fire Catering, and you're making us a paleo-friendly chili recipe, which we were so happy to hear that there even is a paleo-friendly chili recipe.
Yeah, well, I was glad to be asked, because chili is actually one of my favorite things to make, especially as the weather gets colder and people need something that's going to stick to their ribs, so to speak.
Yes.
It's easy if you leave out the beans. So for a lot of people, it's only beans in their chili recipe.
Right.
For other people, it's only chilies. Other people, you cannot have tomatoes. So everyone has their own rules on chili. For me, I don't put beans in my chili anyway. So
okay.
I never did.
So this is a natural thing.
So this
for you.
Is perfect. This is a chili recipe that I actually was won a little award for when I entered a little contest.
Did you now?
Yeah.
So this
so
must be really good.
This is our award-winning chili. So we start off with a little bit of tomato juice, and we have our chopped garlic and fresh chopped onions, okay?
This is and garlic and onions?
That's what's in here.
Okay.
Garlic and onions, and we just had it going for about 2 minutes, okay? And then we're going to put in some diced tomato that we're going to add in here.
Speaking of tomato, is that?
This is about 3 tomatoes worth of tomatoes here that we're going to saute up.
Before we came over here, by the way, Jeff, every single guest that walked out onto our set, they stopped. And they all had this look on their face like, what is that?
Well, this is a big recipe, so I hope they stuck around to eat some. I know the people at home wish they could taste it, but we're gonna see what we can come up with. Now we have some fresh sirloin, and this is a nice lean cut of sirloin. And it's obviously been ground.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So lean, like what percentage are we looking at?
Less than 20% is what I like
less
to use.
Okay.
So you're using a nice lean cut. And you could grind it yourself, or you can have it ground. I definitely recommend, if you can, getting the stuff that's freshly ground behind the counter rather than the stuff that might have been sitting for a while.
Yeah.
And Jeff, while you're talking about that, go over really quickly the paleo diet itself.
Sure.
And why beans are not part of this.
Okay, so essentially what we get to enjoy with the paleo diet are fruits and vegetables, nuts and seeds, and lean proteins. And we leave out dairy, all grains we leave out, and I always remind people that corn is not a vegetable. It is a grain. A lot of people like to have corn as their vegetable.
But
corn isn't everything, so it's kind of tough on that one. But anyway, and we also leave out legumes, which beans are legumes, so that includes peanuts and dry kind of beans.
And why is that? Why do you leave all those things in
place? Essentially, our biology was set up it's sometimes referred to as paleo, as in paleolithic, was set up to be hunters and gatherers. And technology kind of got ahead of ourselves. We started farming and making these foods that fight us when we try to eat them. They're trying to stay alive when we're eating them, and they let out all sorts of chemicals that just don't agree with us and don't allow us to digest the foods we are supposed to eat in the right way.
Yeah, so this is a way to avoid that.
This is, we eat with our biology, whole foods and
working with your body.
And working with your body. And beans just act very much like a grain in that way.
Okay, I didn't know that. Okay.
Yeah. So we have this almost cooked up. We're gonna add a little bit of our tomato paste,
I love tomato
paste. And that's just gonna kick up the flavor a little bit. Now, if you wanted to, a lot of people like to make their chili spicy. So I like a Frank Red Hot as a sauce,
and
you can do as much or as little. Some people like more of a taste of Tabasco. Mm-hmm. I leave that up to you at this point.
Cayenne pepper, would that work?
Cayenne pepper, yes, lots of spices, and that's where people can put their own signature on this.
Yes.
Okay? And I had already had a little salt and pepper. I'm going to add a little bit more for flavor. A little bit of more olive oil. I'm just looking
it's
at
looking
the texture.
It's looking very juicy, very nice.
And it will, and as it sits, the juices will get released as it cooks as well.
Now, is this the kind of chili that's even better the next day when you reheat it?
It is.
So that's what I love about chili, because it's so easy.
And I have some that's done, so
are
you
we
could,
grab
you
this?
Could yeah, if you want to grab that, then I'll grab some forks, and you could tell me.
We can take it. Okay. Never say no to taste testing. Now, what kind of side dishes, like paleo-friendly side dishes, could you serve with this chili?
You know, that's a great question. I think the best thing to go is with your favorite vegetable.
Yeah.
So for me, I'm a big fan of squash. I love, we do a great butternut squash. I love asparagus. And it just sweet potatoes are great, especially when you're not having some of the heavier grain type foods.
And so those, everything you mentioned was a fall.
Yeah,
fall
exactly.
Vegetable.
The fall vegetables that go great with a nice chili.
So good.
Is
and
that
so
good?
Flavorful. Mm-hmm.
Great.
You were mentioning that you can tailor the spice to what you do or don't want.
Exactly. As a matter of fact, I just had a wedding this weekend, mm-hmm. and the folks were from a place that they enjoy, some of the family enjoys really spicy food.
Yeah.
So I made some of the chicken just with the regular spices, and then we kicked up a batch that we offered as well. So different people, even different people within the same group.
Yeah.
So you might want to leave the spice out and have
it's
people add
base.
It themselves.
It's
but
great
it's a
base.
Great base recipe
Jeff,
for
if
sure.
Jeff, people are interested in the paleo diet. You cater, you provide the dishes as well. What can they do for that?
If they want to get 7 prepared meals that I call it ready to heat. So they just take them and pop them in the microwave for about 3 minutes.
Okay.
We deliver those every Wednesday in a cooler with ice packs ready to go, and they'll last you all week. And we do that every Wednesday, and it's they go to passion4paleo.com to find out more. And I also have a class going on October 30th at the Dorothy Lane Market School of Cooking.
Okay,
so that'll be a great chance, too.
Thank you so much, passion4paleo.com, right?
That's right.
Don't go anywhere after the break.